Hey, what's going on, guys? My name is Shane. For those who are new, welcome back if you're returning. I want to start today's video by saying I am not a true crime expert. I am simply a true crime fan. Take anything I say as a speculation, allegation, or opinion unless proven otherwise in the court of law. I don't want to get sued. All right, we talked about Noah Presgrove. Noah was a 19-year-old who was found on the side of the road, incredibly mangled. However, there was an article of clothing believed to be a pair of shorts found near him that were untampered with. So how does a naked 19-year-old body show up on the side of the road and nobody seems to know what happened? I will have the video detailing what we know as of right now down below if you want to check out that video. For today, we're going to be listening to two 911 calls from drivers who passed Noah's body, and both drivers mistook his body for a deer. Once they drove past and looked back in their mirror, they could tell it wasn't a deer, and even one of the drivers mentioned the article of clothing that they saw on the road. Now, neither driver wanted to get too close to the scene, but one of the drivers does block off his body right on the side of the road, right where the white line is, so it could have easily been run over by another vehicle and possibly further damaging more evidence for investigators. So one of the callers does pull his car in such a way that he blocks Noah's body as they wait for law enforcement to arrive. We're going to be looking at True Crimes with Megan on TikTok again as she covered these 911 calls.
Deserve answers, and somebody needs to come forward, and soon. Here are the two 911 calls.
911, what is your emergency?
Hey, on Highway 81 just north of Terral, in between Terral and Ryan, Oklahoma, probably about 3 miles north of Terral, driving down the road, and I had a bunch of cars behind me, but it looked like somebody got hit, like somebody walking down the highway laying on the shoulder of the road.
It looks like somebody's laying in the road?
Like on the shoulder, like maybe they were walking and somebody hit them. Unless it was a deer, it looked like a body.
Okay. You said, so on Highway 81,
in between Ryan and Terral, just north of Terral, probably about 3 miles, it's kind of in a low spot.
Okay. And is that, going to be, I'm trying to think which way that highway runs. Is it going to be on your east, west, north, or south? I'm trying to think. I'm sorry.
It goes north and south. It runs out of Duncan.
Okay. So what side of the road is that on?
It'd be on the west side of the road.
Okay. Let me see who I have on duty to go check that out.
That's it. It looked awful odd.
If you recall, when I first heard about this case, I thought the same thing this driver did. Possibly Noah was intoxicated. We found out that he got in an argument. And I do apologize, by the way. I said that Noah got in an argument with his girlfriend, but I actually believe that it was an ex-girlfriend. So I apologize for misspeaking. However, I thought maybe after that argument, maybe he left his friend's house and decided to go down the road. But what didn't make sense is why, again, he was basically nude. He had on mismatching either socks or shoes. So if he was hit by a car, where did the rest of his clothes go? They wouldn't just dissipate. So that theory went out the window for me, but we're going to listen to the second 911 caller.
911, what is your emergency?
Yes, ma'am. I was driving to work. I'm south of Terral, or north of Terral, south of Ryan.
Yes.
And I'm pretty sure there's somebody laying dead along the road. They look naked. I'm staying back.
Okay, I just had two calls on that, and I have a deputy headed that way.
All right, well, I'm sitting here blocking the road.
Oh, are you there waiting? Okay.
Because the body's laying right on a white line.
Oh, dang, it is a body. He's naked, and he's laying on the white line.
He's naked. White.
I turned around, because I just about hit it, because there's a deer across the road, and I'm like, first I thought it was a deer, and I was talking to a guy I work with. I'm like, I don't think that's a deer.
Yeah, my first caller said, thought it was a deer, and then when he looked back and he said, no, there's no way that's a deer.
No, and it actually looks like there's a piece of clothing maybe laying in the middle of the road now. I don't want to get too close, I just...
Don't scare me right now.
No, this is another 911 call that looking at it.
Oh, she's already been in touch with Jeremy.
Okay. Yeah, Jeremy's going to head that way.
Jeremy's heading that way. She's on the other.
All right.
Okay, so you're staying there, or?
Yeah, I'll just go ahead and make sure nobody runs it over or anything okay. else. I mean,
I have a patron or reporting party staying there until a deputy gets there to okay. block so nobody hits them again.
There is a reporting party is going to sit there with flashers on.
Once again, it's an ongoing investigation, so I'll make sure that I react to any new updates that come out regarding this case. I don't think anybody's going to willingly come out with some information. Maybe someday guilt will eat them up and we'll hear more, but I really hope it doesn't take years or somebody being on their deathbed to finally admit to anything. Maybe it was a freak accident. We really don't know at this point, but again, I will continue to update you guys as more information comes out. So let me know what you guys think below, and I will see you in my next one.